This is Matt Mohammed reporting live from Afghanistan about the war and how it affects the economy. The estimated amount of the war is about $402 to $403 billion, and according to USA Today, the monthly cost of the war in Afghanistan is driven by the troop increases and fighting on difficult terrain, and has topped Iraq's cost for the first time since 2003, and shows no sign of letting up. The Pentagon spending in February, the most recent month available, was $6.7 billion in Afghanistan, compared with a $5.5 billion in Iraq. And the cumulative cost of the war surpasses $1 trillion, including spendings for veteran and foreign aid. Those costs could put increased pressure on the President Obama and the economy, given the $12 trillion debt the nation has. The cost of sending one soldier to the war is roughly about $1 million, and there are roughly about 80,000 plus soldiers there. And this has a serious impact on the dollar, and the government prints more money in order to pay for these costs. And due to the harsh mountainous terrain in Afghanistan, soldiers are prone to ambush and therefore need extra protection, which means that more money is to be spent, and adding onto the enormous debt this economy is in. At a U.S. training camp to show how the Afghan soldiers are trained. They go through a rigorous process of combat training, obstacle course, and physical challenging to show what they are capable of. And here, you see, we are at the training grounds, and we have a couple soldiers right here doing some jumping jacks, and they are obviously not capable because they smoke too much weed and they can't do a jumping jack. And there we go, one is running away. We don't know what he's doing. And now they're both down. Okay. So here we are at an Afghan training base where the United States is pouring $7.5 billion a year into building an Afghan army and police force. It is an uphill task, and most recruits cannot read or write. The Afghan soldiers do not have a great image, even among their own countrymen. And over here we have two soldiers who are doing combat training. And right here you see them two both trying to fight. The soldiers are going through an obstacle course in which they will race to see who is the stronger man. And there we have it. The strongest Afghan soldier I've ever had.
For Allah!
So this is Matt Mohammed reporting live from Afghanistan, showing how the war in Afghanistan affects the economy.
Some of the Afghans relaxed by smoking spliffs.
They love it, don't they? I don't understand how they can smoke it in the middle of a battle. It'd make you worse, but they love it. As soon as they get 2 minutes, they start smoking it and passing it around. all laughing and joking, and then a minute later they're running up towards bullets.
Then the Taliban started firing again on our vulnerable position, reminding everyone of how dangerous a situation we were in. Some of the Afghans casually walked out into the line of fire. One was very lucky not to have been killed. That bullet struck the magazine on his weapon, blasting it off.